Fendi put me on a DVD. Wayne saw me on a DVD. Wayne made a phone call, and next thing you know, I was recording my mixtape. That was Playtime Is Over, my first mixtape. So I've had good luck from the kind of beginning, because that was my first ever mixtape, and freaking Lil Wayne was on it. So he had asked me to be like a part of Young Money, and nobody knew what Young Money was at the time. And I remember he spoke to me on the phone just to say hi and stuff like that. And I was like, I'm working on my mixtape. And he was like, word, send me something. And I didn't really know what that meant, but I figured, I'm like, send me something. Does this mean he's gonna do a verse for the album? I mean, for the mixtape. And I was like, I went crazy.
Call me Nicholas, style defined as ridiculous. I beg your pardon, meet me at the garden. The number one draft, I'm New York's pick. And I don't lose like them dudes on the New York Knicks.
What did he see in your flow that was different from some of the other chicks coming up?
I think I was being real crazy in your face when the DVD, and maybe he just saw like a little crazy chick. And I was spitting some shit on that come up. That was when I was like on my tough guy in the D shit. So he probably was digging those lyrics.
How the fuck you in the game like 10 years strong? Y'all bitches still can't write your own damn song?
I was doing a lot of crazy stuff, like just talking reckless and being crazy, you know? Like, I was just like, I didn't care, you know, at a certain point. We was doing DVDs, and it just felt like you had to be saying the craziest thing to get people's attention at that time.
This is what I use when I want to slap a hoe. You ever got slapped and lick your lip, the shit tastes like money, bitch? And if you gonna drop, you better drop, because when I come out, it's a rizzy.
It's a problem.
It's
a serious problem.
I can't call it.
This is the autobiography of Nicki Minaj.
I felt like people around me were taking advantage of me. They took advantage of the fact that I didn't know the business. So I met Waka's mother, and I went to Atlanta, and I saw that there were apartments in Atlanta for $700. I freaked the hell out. I think I moved there with $2,000. But I had faith in myself because I had already started booking shows. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Remember when I was living in New York, y'all, and I used to do like Boston, Philly, like.
It's Atlanta, right? What part of Georgia? I don't even.
I was doing shows, so I knew that when I got out there, she was a booking agent. I knew that I would get started. I just did it all on faith. I remember I was in my room. I was packing up my room. My mother didn't even think I was serious. I was like, no, I'm really moving. I went there, and then I spent like a week, and then I came back and just packed all my stuff and I'm going back. And because I knew that there was something in Atlanta that I felt, this is my time, or this, I'm gonna
the
make
energy.
It. And I felt with Deb, the way she made me feel, she really, it was like she was my mother and my manager. She made me feel like I got you, and I had never had anyone really, especially not a woman, treat me like that. So I felt so safe with her.
Yeah.
So Safari and I, we drove, we packed all our clothes in our cars, and we drove to Atlanta. For a very long time, I didn't even have furniture in Atlanta. Like, we were just good with knowing that we had an apartment. Well, I already caught Wayne's attention before I moved to Atlanta.
Okay,
yeah.
She's already in place.
But things were going slow. Yeah. Like, it was like Wayne was saying he signed me, but he hadn't signed me. So when I met Deb, she was like, are you signed? I was like, no. You know, and she was like, oh, well, we need to get you signed.
Nicki started with me in 06, 07. I met her on MySpace. She had like a flyer page. I switched it around. Her name was Nicki Minaj when I met her. I changed her name to Nicki Minaj. Nicki didn't like the name Minaj.
My name is really Minaj, and Fendi flipped it to Minaj when I met him.
I named her Nicki Minaj. I gave it to Debbie. On some management shit, which is Waka Moms.
Debbie brainwashed her. Debbie going out there, you know, Debbie got her little tactics. Yo, you know, I guess Debbie hit her with the, well, you know, Nicki Minaj. I don't know about that name. You know, he's trying to take you in the wrong direction.
Nobody could brainwash Nicki. The only thing that he's upset about is I wasn't letting her get on the cover of his DVD named Fat P.U. dot dot dot. And you can fill in the blanks, okay? So all Fendi do is talk shit, shoot DVDs, exploit people, and do what he do. That's it.
The problem came in when Nicki took that picture. I ain't like that picture.
Which picture?
When she took the picture, she squatted with the lollipop.
Okay.
I said to her, you are not Little Kim. Okay? You cannot, not to her, but I said to Fendi, you can't bring Kim back. He was obsessed with that kind of stuff. We had a disagreement because you wanted to put on a front cover and call a super pussy. Totally disrespectful. I was not going for that. You will not put my artist on the front of no cover calling her super pussy. After when we talked, you know, we talked about a lot of stuff and she's like, Dab, I really don't want to do that. I'm going to back her. Even though that's not who I am. You don't have to sell sex. She's a very pretty girl, period. No matter what people say, she's very pretty. She had skills. She had talent. It was there.
I don't want to hold nobody artist. Give me 180 days, I get you a major deal. If not, you walk away. I got the Young Money deal in like, it took me like 70 days to get the Young Money deal. It was a Young Money, Dirty Money deal. So when I got the contract, Nicki started ducking me. Like, because, you know, Wayne gave me one of those Cash Money contracts from the 80s. Which it was no royalties on it. So I told Nicki, like, yo, I ain't signing this contract. I ain't gonna let you do that to yourself. She started crying.
It's nothing.
Dirty, what he playing around over there, dog?
No, Fendi, fuck Fendi. Oh. No, this is the thing. Fuck Fendi. I put that nigga out. Fendi don't got no motherfucking say in the motherfucking. Come up, DVD, in the motherfucking label.
You see, Fendi's calling me in the middle of our shit. Fendi's always around, even when he's not here.
Fendi.
You just said Fendi's a what? Hey, he's a hater, right? He's a blocker?
He's a blocker.
All right.
I fucks with New York.
Fuck with you too, Weezy.
Yeah, I fucks with y'all.
I'm curious because you're from New York, right, Nicki?
Yes, I am. Queens.
By way of Southside Jamaica, Queens, and I can't believe New York slept because it took Weezy from the South to come holler at you, right?
You know, he happens to be from the South. I'm just happy that he chose me. You know what I'm saying? If niggas from New York didn't holler at me, that's their loss. I'm not worried about it, but I still got love for them.
Okay, what you guys say to all the haters that say Nicki had to fuck Lil Wayne to get on?
Lewinsky is just, you know, a statement of pussy power. It's just about elevating yourself and, you know, being around the presidents and not being a fool, just being, you know, getting yourself in the right door.
You think when you come out, though, you think people are going to be like, oh, this is not Lil' Kim?
Now, you put out the poster, the infamous poster that Lil' Kim did back in, like, 96.
Because you know what Minaj means. That's like three people, right?
No, Minaj means anything you want it to mean. You know what I mean? But that's my point. It
I know
can
the
mean,
hood Minaj means a couple niggas fucking. Hip-hop, fucking. Yeah. R&B, fucking.
She said, fuck Fendi, but I think she was playing. I heard she moved them things, I think she fucking Wayne. She call herself Lewinsky, that means she give him brain. She tryna be like Lil' Kim, her picture looks the same. Why she ain't signed with G-Unit, she from Queens, right? And what's her nationality, she Chinese, right? I mean, she okay, but she ain't all that. She ain't the next bitch, tell that bitch fall back. See, I'm a hater, I go hard, listen, let's begin. You know her last name Minaj, she a lesbian. And she ain't never coming out, thick and currency. But every time she do an interview, you know I run this seat. She get me so sick and make me vomit. That's why I spend my time online leaving comments. And you know that I got some more haters with me. Might hit up this is 50, MTV hit up BET. Tell them pretty, please don't play Nicki.
Still I rise, still I fight, still I fight. Crack a smile, keep my eyes on the prize. See my haters tell them hi. One day you'll remember this, one day when we reminisce. Nothing I do ever is good enough for the music biz.
For you.
What's your current situation? I mean, you know, I know you're working with Lil Wayne, but like, are you intending on going to a major? You want to try to go indie first?
Yeah,
all right,
give me some time.
So all you majors out there, stay focused.
still a free agent.
Fendi never really like had a label situation, you know? He had like the Come Up DVD, which did a lot to boost my career and stuff like that. But he never really had like a label situation. And then I was looking for management at the time. He wasn't a manager. So I have management now. And, you know, that's it. I'm still, like, you know, I still do my thing with, like, the Young Money artists and stuff like that. So nothing is really that different. I mean, shout out to my auntie, you know, my new management company. I'm really excited. In a couple months, a lot of shit is about to explode for me, so I can't wait.
Hey, what's up, guys? Nicki Minaj. Sit
your ass down. Well, E.I. called me. He was, like, the president of Young Money. He called me up. He was like, yo, why Nicki out here on the I Am Music Tour without you? I'm like, Nicki on the I Am Music Tour?
Well, who was on the I Am Music Tour at the time?
T-Pain, Wayne, okay. They had Drake open up. Everybody had, like, open the sections.
Okay.
So I was like, what Nicki doing on the I Am Music Tour? He was like, yo, I don't know, but you need to be out here. So I flew out to a date they had in Chicago. And I saw Nicki. I was like, yo, what's up? She walked right past me.
I wanted to let the world see my people that y'all know. Go ahead and say what I'm going to say. You know what I'm saying? Y'all already know we got
I'ma need my badges and my ribbons. Maybe it'll make up for everything that I wasn't given. Everything that I've given, I swear I've never given. Just look at what I've been in, and this is just the beginning. I do it, cause I did it for my ballerina. Blowing kisses to the soldiers, I am Marilyn Monroe. When we shoot them up. Camouflage me, cause Young Money is a Navy. Yo. Better yet, the Army.
Better strap up your boots before they start to shoot. Do it for the truth. It's Young Money salute. 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 Salute.
You good, bro?
It just feel good to be tall, you know. He one of us, you know, it's all about over, really being over 6 feet.
I didn't realize it was popping to be tall like that, but it is sexy. I'm going upstairs, and all the Young Money is about to perform. I mean, some of them.
Here goes Drizzy. You about to perform?
It was exciting, but you know, more than just being exciting, like on a fun level, it was like just learning the business, because obviously I had never gone on tour before. So then I got to see like how important it is to do hot music so that you can do shit like that, because the level he's at and the people that were there, it was just like amazing. Like you. I just met him on a bus, and we talked for a long time about the industry. I remember I was like shaking, you know, when I met him.
Hi, you guys. I'm Nicki Minaj.
Hi, I am Nicki Minaj. Excuse me. What? Isn't this messed up? The president is this crazy? Like, who has a president like this? Making fun of his artist. Making fun of his artist. Okay. My name is Nicki Minaj, aka Nicki Lewinsky. It's going down.
Batman pull up, watch thing now, do the Batman pull up. Batman forward, Batman pull up. Watch, no, let's catch up. Batman forward, Batman pull up.
Never, I don't dance. Oh. I don't know what's going on over there, bro.
That's just how Young Money do.
It was a dope experience. I would not trade it for the world. It gave me a glimpse on the business. And I stress business because it wasn't playtime. It was very, wow, this is what the business is going to be like. And it made me come back off that tour and go in.
So you are signed to Young Money?
No. Well, I'm not as a major, like a major deal. I'm still in the process of getting that. We're in New York for a week, you know, talking to a few people and a few labels, put their bids in and stuff like that. So we're going to make that decision pretty soon.
However, I am not signed to a major record company. We are in a negotiation process. As far as Gucci, shout out to Gucci, that's my baby. He and I have the same manager. So that's why you saw me all of a sudden doing a whole bunch of stuff with Gucci.
I'm gonna need some honey.
So I've been trying for a long time, and it just goes to show you, like, you know what, if you really want something, you work hard at it, you know what I'm saying? Eventually people will come around. It's just up to you to stick with it. I think the problem is a lot of people just give up.
Gucci, go and get the camper. White girls too. Ooh, Julie, Amy, Amber.
Because it's so difficult, you know. You want to go, and you know, it's like you got bills to pay, you can't keep on going to the studio, you gotta do this. So a lot of people just give up, but I just didn't. I just kept working.
Let me hear that punch. Just a punch. Alright, keep that. Let me get that punch again.
Minaj is the name. It's me and Gucci tag team. WrestleMania brain.
Put my fucking boots out, because these bitches don't know who the fuck I am. You know what I'm saying? I tried to tell them I'm Nicki Minaj. You know what I'm saying? When y'all motherfuckers see me, y'all bitches better sue me. The fuck out. It's funny, like, people actually are starting to know my face and my name, but they, you know, so now my focus is music. I like it. Because you went hard. I heard you. I was like, you not gonna embody me that crazy. I think I'm gonna do one more take, try to swag it, because I still think my swag is on a 6. I need it to be on a 10 right now. I'm gonna try one more. I mean, I'm a perfectionist. Like, I'm my worst critic, so that's why you saw me in here writing this verse for, like, the last hour and a half. I'm not like Gucci and Wayne yet. You know, they come and they do it in 2 minutes. I might take 2 hours, but I do it, like, when I do it, it get done.
You're easier than my lollipop picture. I be up top, popping on the jigsaw.
I'm on the grind, you know? I can't do nothing but grind right now. I'm excited. Shout out to So Icy, shout out to Gucci. Gucci done teamed up with, you know what I'm saying, the baddest bitch on the planet. I done teamed up with the craziest, most creative nigga in the motherfucking game right now.
Wow, that's
no, I'm saying wow, cause the way Gucci comes in, like, right there, like, this sound crazy. That shit sound good. Well, the difference between me and them right now is that I'm hungry. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm ready. I'm working on an original album. I'm working with the whole So Icy Entertainment team now. I'm out in Atlanta. Shout out to Mazay Entertainment and So Icy. And shout out to Young Money and Dirty Money as well. But I'm doing a lot of work with them. I just finished doing a lot of stuff with, like, Gucci Mane. And
I kind of was just doing my own thing a lot because, you know, Wayne is not the type of person that, like, babies anybody. You know, every artist on Young Money gotta fend for themselves. And I think that's what people don't realize. Like, you can't just be up around Young Money and think you're just gonna be on Young Money. If you want something to happen, you gotta make it happen yourself.
Oh, Lil Wayne's the man.
Oh, snap.
What's it like being a part of the Lil Wayne camp? I don't really see him a lot no more because he's, you know what I'm saying, he extra now. The nigga done sold 1 million in 1 week. Now he's got shout out to the
okay. Right.
Shout out to Young Money. They in LA shooting their video. I couldn't be there, but shout out to my babies. I love y'all.
You know, New York rides for New York. So for you to rock with a Southern rap team?
Yeah, but no, New York team came at me. At a very early stage in my rap career, I was making 6 figures for shows. If I heard there was another rapper making that, I thought, you know what, I get out there and command a crowd. I get out there and make my fans happy. I want that too. And I think women have the tendency to feel that they shouldn't ask to be compensated as much as a man doing the same exact thing. If you know you're great at what you do, don't ever be ashamed to ask for the top dollar in your field.
Something magical happens when you do what you love. And whether it's loved by the masses or not, there's magic in that genuine love that you have for your own art, and it could never be taken away. And then little by little, people start catching on. So just follow your heart and don't be afraid.
I appeal to all of them. I appeal to the older bad bitches. I appeal to the young girls that be like, Nicki, I love you. You know, you're my big sister. You're my idol. Like, I haven't even dropped the album yet, and I have girls calling me their idol.
Yeah. Well, you want to bundle up? Why don't you? You're going to welcome me? Thank you so much. Okay. We got, I love you so much, honey. Thank you for coming.
No problem.
Bye, mama. That's what I thought.